Ready? Father, know the Son, know the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Leta hiyo jembe.
Ndiye msushie aka hapo. Na picha tujachukua.
Who is going?
We're going to walk down that passage.
Hey, Buddha, Buddha, Buddha.
What I'm seeing is that there will be a need to tile. This thing is with dust, they are never finished.
The letter is in the right direction first, insofar as it observes that there are people who appear committed to undermining the handshake between Raila Amolo Odinga and Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. And there are people within our NASA coalition, including some of the principals, who have become so rattled by the handshake that instead of waiting to understand it and waiting to help implement it, they are choosing to run away. But on the president's side, it is also clear that there are people who are so rattled by it that they have chosen to do things that would diminish the faith of the population in that handshake. And they do it in a variety of ways. It includes disobedience of court orders that they think would demonstrate that the government respects the court towards unity. It includes making sure that Dr. Miguna does not access this country. It includes issuing checks to compensate for cattle while there are people whose lives were lost and there's no talk of compensation. And so it is important and it is true that the focus should be on the handshake and on the issues that are raised, and those who are seeking to undermine it from either side ought to be discouraged. The letter is also true insofar as it observes that there are people who are obsessed with the presidential race of 2022. In coming together, Raila and Uhuru stated very clearly that that handshake was not about 2022. That handshake was about addressing the very many fundamental issues that have bedeviled this country for decades and which hopefully could be addressed beyond 2022. But while that is so, it can be observed that the deputy president is clearly focusing on 2022. And in doing so, he is actually singularly seeking to undermine that handshake and what it stands for. So to that extent, those observations by Senator Wako are right. The only respect in which I would not agree with him is that he need not send a joint letter to Raila Amolo Odinga and Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. The steps and the issues and the instances that seek to undermine the handshake have singularly come from the side of the government, not from Raila's side. And so if anybody is to be addressed, it is the president to be told that in meeting and having that handshake, Raila Amolo Odinga has shown great magnanimity. It is important that the president reins in those within his ranks who appear to want to undermine that. Because if they undermine it, then it reduces public confidence in the authority of that handshake. So it is only to that extent that I do not agree with Senator Emmaus Wako.